pray that the peace of Christ is with all of us this morning as God has given us a new day of life. Good morning, everyone. God bless you. Welcome to the Good Book Project. Here at this channel in our Chronological Bible in a Year video podcast, we have reached day 192, all to the glory of God. Today is Tuesday, July the 11th in the year of our Lord, 2023. Yesterday for day 191, we were in the book of Isaiah, reading chapters 5 through 8, which included a bunch of things, included now the parable of the Lord's people being a vineyard that dry up and get cut off. We read of Isaiah being called to be a prophet when the Lord asks who would speak for him, and Isaiah said, "Send me, here I am." We also read now of foreign invasion being predicted, as well as it being specified to be the king of Assyria and the Assyrians who will come and destroy the people. We also have a prophecy of a person being born to a virgin, a son named Emmanuel, and we know that to be our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For today, day 192, we take a pause in the book of Isaiah to read one of his contemporaries operating at the same time as Isaiah is receiving his vision in Judah for the people of Judah. We are going to be reading a sheep herder, a shepherd named Amos. I will pray us into the word and we will get right into it. Lord, we come before you today in the mighty name of Jesus, thanking you once again for bringing us to another day to read your word. Thank you that every single day you've allowed us and you've protected us and you've given us the strength to stop what we're doing and hear your perfect word. We love you and we bless you for that. Lord, I pray over the book of Amos and that you use it to bless us and that you open up our eyes so we could see new perspective on what is happening at this time. I pray that you open up our eyes to speak through us, through your prophet, in your holy word, so we could have application for our lives, so your word can always be a guide to us. We ask for all these things in the name of Jesus, and we all say, Amen. For today, day 192, we begin a new book of the Bible, the book of Amos. And we're going to do this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Word of God reads. The Book of Amos. Amos 1. The words of Amos, who was amongst the herdsmen of Tekoa, which he saw concerning Israel in the days of Uzziah, king of Judah, and in the days of Jeroboam, the son of Joash, king of Israel, 2 years before the earthquake. He said, "The Lord will roar from Zion, and utter his voice from Jerusalem, and the pastures of the shepherds will mourn, and the top of Carmel will wither." The Lord says, "Three transgressions of Damascus, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment. Because they have threshed Gilead with threshing instruments of iron. But I will send a fire into the house of Hazael, and it will devour the palaces of Ben-Hadad. I will break the bar of Damascus and cut off the inhabitant from the valley of Avon and him who holds the scepter from the house of Eden. And the people of Syria shall go into captivity to Kir, says the Lord." The Lord says, "Three transgressions of Gaza, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment. Because they carried away captive the whole community to deliver them up to Edom. But I will send a fire on the wall of Gaza, and it will devour its palaces. I will cut off the inhabitant from Ashdod, and him who holds the scepter to Ashkelon, from Ashkelon, and I will turn my hand against Ekron. And the remnant of the Philistines will perish, says the Lord God." The Lord says, "For three transgressions of Tyre, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment. Because they delivered up the whole community to Edom and didn't remember the brotherly covenant, but I will send a fire on the wall of Tyre, and it will devour its palaces." The Lord says, "For three transgressions of Edom, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment, because he pursued his brother with the sword and cast off all pity, and his anger raged continually, and he kept his wrath forever. But I will send a fire on Teman, and it will devour the palaces of Bozrah." The Lord says, for three transgressions of the children of Ammon. Yes, for four. I will not turn away its punishment, because they have ripped open the pregnant women of Gilead, that they may enlarge their border. But I will kindle a fire in the wall of Rabbah, and it will devour its palaces with shouting in the battle of day, in the day of battle. With a storm in the wind of the whirlwind, with a storm in the day of the whirlwind, and their king will go into captivity, he and his princes together, says the Lord. Amos 2. The Lord says, for three transgressions of Moab, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment, because he burnt the bones of the king of Edom into lime. But I will send a fire on Moab, and it will devour the palaces of Kerioth, and Moab will die with tumult, with shouting, and with the sound of the trumpet. And I will cut off the judge from amongst them, and will kill all its princes with him, says the Lord. The Lord says, for three transgressions of Judah, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment, because they have rejected the Lord's law and have not kept his statutes, and their lies have led them astray, after which their fathers walked. But I will send a fire on Judah, and it will devour the palaces of Jerusalem. The Lord says, for three transgressions of Israel, yes, for four, I will not turn away its punishment, because they have sold the righteous for silver, and the needy for a pair of sandals. They trample the heads of the poor into the dust of the earth, and deny justice to the oppressed. A man and his father use the same maiden to profane my holy name. They lay themselves down beside every altar on clothes taken in pledge. In the house of their God they drink the wine of those who have been fined. Yet I destroyed the Amorite before them, whose height was like the height of the cedars, and he was strong as the oaks. Yet I destroyed his fruit from above, and his roots from beneath. Also I brought you up out of the land of Egypt, and led you 40 years in the wilderness to possess the land of the Amorite. I raised up some of your sons for prophets, and some of your young men for Nazarites. Isn't it true, you children of Israel? Says the Lord. But you gave the Nazarites wine to drink, and commanded the prophets, saying, don't prophesy. Behold, I will crush you in your place, as a cart crushes that is full of grain. Flight will perish from the swift. The strong won't strengthen his force. The mighty won't deliver himself. He who handles the bow won't stand. He who is swift of foot won't escape. He who rides the horse won't deliver himself. He who is courageous amongst the mighty will flee away naked on that day, says the Lord. Amos 3. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, you children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up out of the land of Egypt, saying, I have only chosen you of all the families of the earth. Therefore I will punish you for all of your sins. Do two walk together unless they have agreed? Will a lion roar in the thicket when he has no prey? Does a young lion cry out of his den if he has caught nothing? Can a bird fall in a trap on the earth where no snare is set for him? Does a snare spring up from the ground when there is nothing to catch? Does the trumpet alarm sound in a city, without the people being afraid? Does evil happen to a city, and the Lord hasn't done it? Surely the Lord God will do nothing, unless he reveals his secret to his servants, the prophets. The lion has roared. Who will not fear? The Lord God has spoken. But who can but prophesy? Proclaim in the palaces at Ashdod, and in the palaces in the land of Egypt, and say, assemble yourselves on the mountains of Samaria, and see what unrest is in her, and what oppression is amongst them. Indeed, they don't know to do right, says the Lord, who hoard plunder and loot in their palaces. Therefore, the Lord God says, an adversary will overrun the land, and he will pull down your strongholds, and your fortresses will be plundered. The Lord says, as the shepherd rescues out of the mouth of the lion two legs, or a piece of an ear, so shall the children of Israel be rescued, who sit in Samaria on the corner of a couch, and on the silken cushions of a bed. Listen and testify against the house of Jacob, says the Lord God, the God of armies. For in the day that I visit the transgressions of Israel on him, I will also visit the altars of Bethel, and the horns of the altar will be cut off and fall to the ground. I will strike the winter house with the summer house, and the houses of ivory will perish, and the great houses will have an end, says the Lord. Amos 4. Listen to this word, you cows of Bashan, who are on the mountain of Samaria, who oppresses the poor, who crush the needy, who tell their husbands, bring us drinks. The Lord God has sworn by his holiness. Behold, the days shall come on you that they will take you away with hooks, and the last of you with fish hooks. You will go out at the breaks in the wall, everyone straight before her, and you will cast yourselves into Harmon, says the Lord. Go to Bethel and sin, to Gilgal and sin more. Bring your sacrifices every morning, your tithes every 3 days. Offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving of that which is leavened, and proclaim free will offerings and brag about them. For this pleases you, you children of Israel, says the Lord God. I also have given you cleanness of teeth in all your cities, and lack of bread in every town. Yet you haven't returned to me, says the Lord. I also have withheld the rain from you, when there were yet 3 months to the harvest, and I caused it to rain on one city, and caused it not to rain on another. One field was rained on, and the field where it didn't rain withered. So 2 or 3 cities staggered to one city to drink water, and were not satisfied. Yet you haven't returned to me, says the Lord. I struck you with blight and mildew many times in your gardens and your vineyards, and the swarming locusts have devoured your fig trees and your olive trees. Yet you haven't returned to me, says the Lord. I sent plagues amongst you. Like I did Egypt, I have slain your young men with the sword, and have carried away your horses. I filled your nostrils with the stench of your camp. Yet you haven't returned to me, says the Lord. I have overthrown some of you, as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah, and you were like a burning stick plucked out of the fire. Yet you haven't returned to me, says the Lord. Therefore I will do this to you, Israel, because I will do this to you. Prepare to meet your God, Israel. For behold, he who forms the mountains, creates the wind, declares to man what is his thought, who makes the morning darkness and treads on the high places of the earth. The Lord, the God of armies, is his name. Amos 5. Listen to this word which I take up for a lamentation over you, O house of Israel. The virgin of Israel has fallen. She shall rise no more. She is cast down on her land. There is no one to raise her up. For the Lord God says, the city that went down, went out 1,000, shall have 100 left, and that which went out 100 shall have 10 left to the house of Israel. For the Lord says to the house of Israel, Seek me, and you will live. But don't seek Bethel, nor enter Gilgal. And don't pass to Beersheba. For Gilgal shall surely go into captivity, and Bethel shall come to nothing. Seek the Lord, and you will live, lest he break out like fire in the house of Joseph, and it devour, and there be no one to quench it in Bethel. You who turn justice to wormwood, and cast down righteousness to the earth, seek him who made the Pleiades and Orion, and turns the shadow of death into the morning, and makes the day dark with night, who calls for the waters of the sea, and pours them out on the surface of the earth, the Lord is his name, who brings sudden destruction on the strong, so that destruction comes on the fortress. They hate him who reproves in the gate, and they abhor him who speaks blamelessly. Therefore, because you trample on the poor and take taxes from him of wheat, you have built houses of cut stone, but you will not dwell in them. You have planted pleasant vineyards, but you shall not drink their wine. For I know how many are your offenses, and how great are your sins. You who afflict the just, who take a bribe, who turn away the needy in the courts. Therefore, a prudent person keeps silent in such a time, for it is an evil time. Seek good, and not evil, that you may live. And so the Lord, the God of armies, will be with you. Hate evil, love good, and establish justice in the courts. It may be that the Lord, the God of armies, will be gracious to the remnant of Joseph. Therefore, the Lord, the God of armies, the Lord says, wailing will be in all the wide ways. They will say in all the streets, alas, alas. They will call the farmer to mourning, and those who are skillful in lamentation to wailing. In all vineyards there will be wailing, for I will pass through the middle of you, says the Lord. Woe to you who desire the day of the Lord! Why do you long for the day of the Lord? It is darkness and not light, as if a man fled from a lion, and a bear met him. Or he went into the house, and leaned his hand on the wall, and a snake bit him. Won't the day of the Lord be darkness and not light? Even very dark and no brightness in it. I despise your feasts, and I can't stand your solemn assemblies. Yes, though you offer me your burnt offerings and meal offerings, I will not accept them. Neither will I regard the peace offerings of your fat animals. Take away from me the noise of your songs. I will not listen to the music of your harps. But let justice roll on like rivers, and righteousness like a mighty stream. Did you bring to me sacrifices and offerings in the wilderness 40 years, house of Israel? You also carried the tent of your king and the shrine of your images, the star of your God, which you made for yourselves. Therefore I will cause you to go into captivity beyond Damascus, says the Lord, whose name is the God of armies. Thank you, Lord, for your perfect word. Heavy, heavy, heavy. The prophet Amos, when receiving these words of the Lord, the Lord we see here is very strict and very firm. We see at this time, now being a contemporary to Isaiah, meaning they're both receiving prophecies and visions around the same time, while Isaiah is primarily speaking to the people of Judah, Amos is speaking to the northern kingdom of Israel. Now, because we read here all of the injustice that is going on, the Lord lists all of the peoples that are around Israel and around Judah. The Edomites, the Moabites, the people from Damascus, all of them he is naming to say that justice will fall on them eventually, and they won't be able to escape the justice of the Lord. And he also mentions Judah on how they also won't be. And he gives the harshest punishment to Israel. And at this time, what is Israel doing? The Lord says here that Israel has become increasingly idolatry worshiping people. And mostly they are unjust. They are not operating in justice. They are operating in unrighteousness. And this the Lord hates. He says, you take from the needy. You step on the poor. You make the Nazarites. Now remember, the Nazarites all the way back from the book of Numbers were men who were consecrated to the Lord to never drink anything, to never cut any hair on their head or on their bodies, and to be consecrated to the Lord. And yet the Israelites are making all of the Nazarites go against their vows to the Lord. We read also of all of the injustice throughout all of the chapters that the Lord is angry about, and thus he won't take away his justice from all of these things going on in the land of Israel. The prophet Amos giving out this prophecy to the northern kingdom of Israel at the center in Bethel, because that is where the king resided and also where the main idolatry was going on. So we see here the Lord speaking after Jeroboam, who was the king of Israel at the time, silencing all of the prophets, do not speak, do not prophesy, that Jeroboam tried to shut down the Lord, but of course he couldn't, and the Lord will raise up who he wants and who is willing. A shepherd, in this case from Tekoa, from the land of Judah, named Amos. And now Amos comes and speaks for the Lord and tells all of them all of these things. Everyone is condemned. No one will escape the wrath of God, nor not be dealt with in justice by the Lord for their transgressions against him. And with that, day 192 is complete, and I'm so happy you were able to make it out today to hear the word of God. Please like this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. We're going an entire 365 days in this year, if the Lord wills, so that we could go through his word and get it out to everyone. Also, if you are subscribed, hit the notification bell so you can get a notification for every single time one of our videos goes up. And also, you have my full permission to share this on all and any of your social media. It's not about the numbers. Lord, increase the numbers for the glory of his name. This has nothing to do with us. This is to get the word out for people who need to hear it. I will praise out of the word for today, and we will go throughout the rest of our day. Lord, we just come before you today, thanking you once again for allowing us to go through your word. Thank you that you've given us your word that we can base our lives off of, and we can see the character of you and how people are at this time. Lord, expand our knowledge so that we can thread together all of the needles in order so we could continue to understand and comprehend this perfect story as we have been doing so far. Lord, I pray over the rest of today and that you bless today and that you bless us and that we may be a blessing to others. Please let us be bold for the gospel of Jesus Christ. Please fill us with your Holy Spirit that we may go and be bold of the gospel and at all times ready to share it. We love you, Father. We love you, Son. We love you, Holy Spirit, the triune God, the only true God, the perfect God. We bless you and we thank you. And we ask for all of these things in the mighty name of Jesus. And we all say, amen. Now, the prophet Amos, his book is very dense and it's very nuanced. So I encourage you to read this in a couple different translations. Go through the book a couple times as we continue on in reading the book, that we may pick up all of the different details and all of the different nuances that the Lord is trying to show us through the prophet Amos. And with that, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance toward you and give you peace.